Hello and welcome to In-Depth. I'm Rajat Kane. The year 2018 ended with a bang in a round of frenzied celebrations and partying across the globe. In many ways, the festivities seem to be an indication of hopes and the expectations from a new year. As we enter the year 2019, the calendar is full, replete with events and milestones awaiting to be achieved. There are also challenges that have to be overcome in all spheres, from politics to economy, sports and space. India has a full political calendar with elections of all sizes, a general election that will in all probability engage the nation in April and May, economic challenges that need to be closely watched and overcome, sporting battles to be won in the international arena as well. The year is expected to throw up significant outcomes across some major countries. Our in-depth edition today is all about these issues and events that will be in focus for India and the world. Before we go over to expectations and outlook for year 2019, let's look at the way the world welcomed the new year. Fireworks, dance and music set the mood. It was one big global party that stretched across major cities in Asia, Europe, Africa and the Americas.
Fireworks, concerts, spiritual services and political addresses marked the transition of 2019 as revelers round the globe bid farewell to 2018. The party atmosphere swept across many cities in Asia, Europe, Africa and the America as the clock ticked past midnight. To prevent untoward incidents and protect crowds, the security situation was tightened everywhere. Australia and New Zealand were among the first to welcome the arrival of 2019 in fine style with displays of fireworks watched by millions of people. Australia's largest city, Sydney, put on its biggest ever fireworks display in a spectacular welcome to the new year, kicking off a wave of celebrations for billions around the world. A record amount of pyrotechnics as well as new firework effects and colours lit up the city's skyline for 12 minutes and dazzled the more than 1.5 million spectators who packed the harbour front and parks. Festive lights splashed the night sky of Dubai as the city held an impressive celebration. The skyline across the city was filled with an array of colours and smoke as a spellbinding fireworks display flew across the Burj Khalifa Tower, the world's tallest building in the United Arab Emirates city. More than 1 lakh people descended on London for the capital's official New Year's Eve party in the heart of the city. The skyline was filled with an array of colours as dazzling fireworks exploded over the Thames, ensuring the new year arrived with a bang. In India too, people were in a great festive mood. Delhiites ushered in the new year with songs and dances at various places. One of the country's favourite holiday destinations, Goa, also welcomed the new year with sparkling celebrations. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Now, all major political parties are gearing for high-stakes general election and legislative assembly elections in multiple states scheduled to be held this year. The BJP-led NDA government will contest to regain a second consecutive term at the centre, while the opposition parties, led by the Congress, are trying hard to stitch a grand alliance to stop the BJP-led NDA from returning to power. The year 2019 is also of immense importance for India's forays into space and technology. ISRO has planned 32 missions that include 14 launch vehicles, 17 satellites and one tech demo missions. Here is a detailed report on what awaits us in both these fields.
2019 is a politically significant year for India. The country will witness key events in the political sphere in the coming months, including the all-important general elections and the legislative assembly elections in multiple states. The general election will take place in April-May. Dates for the elections are likely to be declared by the Election Commission sometime in March, following which the Model Code of Conduct will come into effect. The BJP-led NDA government will contest to regain a second consecutive term. The Lok Sabha elections for them will be a referendum on their work done in the last 5 years. While the opposition parties led by the Congress are trying hard to stitch a grand alliance to stop the BJP-led NDA from returning to power.
The government's tenure is coming to an end. The Lok Sabha is already meeting in the penultimate session of the winter session, which is going to end on the 8th of January this year. Adding to that, of course, will be 3 or 4 assembly elections, which will be going simultaneously around the time of Lok Sabha. Of course, one is Andhra Pradesh. Then we have elections to other states of Odisha. Now, these are also very important states because they are states where you have the regional parties in power. In Andhra Pradesh, of course, you know it is the Telangana, the Telugu Desam, and Odisha, and the Biju Janata Dal. But if you come back to the bigger one is the national elections. And of course, because everybody knows the country had elected after a very long time, a very government with 282 majority on its own, the Bharatiya Janata Party under Prime Minister Narendra Modi formed the government in May of 2014. So the tenure is coming to an end. This is the last home stretch.
Alongside the Lok Sabha polls, at least 4 states, Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Odisha and Sikkim, will witness assembly polls in April-May. In Andhra Pradesh, N. Chandrababu Naidu's Telugu Desam Party will contest to retain power. Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy's YSRCP is hoping to trounce the TDP this time. In Odisha, Naveen Patnaik's Biju Janata Dal is battling anti-incumbency after being in power for 18 years. The party is facing challenge from Congress as well as the BJP. In Sikkim, Chief Minister Pawan Kumar Chamling is hoping to retain power for the 6th consecutive term. Chamling has occupied the state's top office for over 24 years and is the longest serving Chief Minister in the country. His Sikkim Democratic Front would compete against the state's main opposition party, Sikkim Krantikari Morcha. Another state in the northeast, Arunachal Pradesh, will head for assembly polls in April-May. In 2014, the Congress had formed the government, having won 42 out of 60 seats in the assembly. But a number of MLAs later moved to the BJP, helping the party form a government. Chief Minister Pema Khandu is facing challenge from Congress and other regional parties. Jammu and Kashmir, which is currently under President's rule, is also expected to witness assembly polls along with the Lok Sabha elections. Further, in the second half of 2019, Maharashtra, Jharkhand and Haryana will also go to polls to elect new legislative assemblies. All 3 states are being ruled by the BJP currently.
It has to go to the people and seek mandate on the work it did and also telling what others can't do, both ways. For the opposition, it's easy. Easier in the sense the challenge remains. To get the BJP out of power is not an easy thing. But attacking a government is always easier than defending a government.
The year 2019 is also of immense importance for India's forays into space technology. In the coming months, ISRO has planned 32 missions that include 14 launch vehicles, 17 satellites and 1 tech demo mission. Besides, ISRO is targeting an early 2019 launch of Chandrayaan 2, the country's second moon mission and the first that will attempt to land. Chandrayaan 2 consists of an orbiter, a lander and a rover. The lander will carry instruments like a seismometer and a thermal probe, while the rover will carry spectrometers to analyze the lunar surface. The year will also see the space agency meeting the country's high throughput bandwidth requirement of Digital India and also in-flight connectivity with the launch of GSAT-20. ISRO also aims to attain operational geo-imaging capability through the GISAT series, which will reinstate the microwave remote sensing capability of RISAT. The payload capability of GSLV and its variants will also be progressively improved, Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
On the economic front, there are many focus areas for Indian citizens. The Indian economy is projected to be the fastest growing major economy in the current and upcoming fiscal 2019-20. According to recent World Bank report, India has improved its ranking in the ease of doing business to 77th rank in the year 2018, and by keeping its reform trajectory intact, it's expected to improve its performance even further.
New India is betting big on the India growth story. For much of the year, India remained ahead of China to retain the tag of world's fastest growing large economy. Along the way, it withstood many ups and downs, a spike in oil prices, and even a looming global trade war-like situation in 2018.
Capacity, institutional capacity. So at one level, what has happened is, and if you look at 2019 now specifically coming in, we see that there's been a lot of institutional development. There's been a lot of things which helped the economy to grow. They have all come together. For instance, GST. It was a difficult tax to start off with, but we have been able to make it work. Not only that, India has improved its ease of doing business. It has come down, it has improved its position to 77th. Which is a very powerful ranking. It is also reflected in the fact that in several other indicators, like on corruption, on transparency, India has been improving.
GDP growth in the first quarter of 2018 and 19, ending 30th June, was 8.2% after 7.7% in the first 3 months of the year. The GDP growth rate then slipped to 7.1% in the quarter ended 30th September. But year is expected to see more reforms accelerating growth to around 7.8% along with more private investment.
When it is in a shape to do business, naturally its growth should also show that thing. And it's not surprising that Indian economy's growth is one of the fastest in the world. At plus 7%, it has been consistently been logging the fastest growth, and it's now already the sixth largest economy in the world. This momentum is actually now coming together. So actually we do see a very powerful growth impulse coming along. And when that growth impulse comes along, you know, favorable things like, for instance, the recent dip in oil prices, those help the economy.
Year 2019 will be dominated by the debate on farm loan waiver announcements. Big states including Karnataka, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh announced them last year. In election year 2019, more states are expected to join them. Year 2018 ended with a new governor at the helm of the RBI. Former Economic Affairs Secretary Shakti Kant Das was named to the post, but not before a public showdown between the NDA government and the RBI. Both differed on several issues, from the central bank's governance, government demand for RBI's excess reserves, watering down the prompt corrective action plan, and regulation of country's payments system. The coming year will be closely watched for the solutions that both the government and the RBI manage to work out on these issues. On the NPAs, the RBI had good news at the end of the last year. Its financial stability report said the quality of banks showed an improvement, with gross non-performing assets ratio of SCBs had declined from 11.5% in March 2018 to 10.8% in September 2018. More progress is expected in the course of the year. Banking sector mess dominated the economy in 2018. At least 11 public sector banks are under prompt corrective action plan of the RBI on account of their weak financial position. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
For the sports enthusiast, 2019 has an array of sporting action. From much awaited ICC World Cup in England to Wimbledon to FIFA Under 17 World Cup. Here's a look at the sporting calendar of the year 2019.
He's crashed into the stumps.
Has a packed sports calendar with a big ticket events lined up all across the year. First up for Indian cricket fans, the ICC World Cup 2019, which is being billed as the biggest spectacle of the year. The coveted cricket tournament will start from May 30th to July 14th. The World Cup will be held in England and Wales. hosts England go in as favourites, while Australia are the defending champions. A lot of focus will also be on Virat Kohli-led Team India. This will also be the first World Cup that will feature no associate members. Next up is the 2019 FIFA Women's World Cup in France. For the first time, France will be hosting the event. It is the 8th edition of the tournament, and the 24-team event will be played across 9 cities in France. The tournament will be played between June 7th and July 7th, with the US coming in as defending champions. Ashes, the high-voltage cricket series pitting England and Australia, will see the action shift to England this year. Australia come into the series as the defending holders, having won the series in 2017 and 18. The 5-test series will be played at Edgbaston, Lords, Headingley, Old Trafford and the Oval. The series is being played later than usual owing to the ODI World Cup earlier in the year. Ashes will be part of the 2019-21 ICC World Test Championship format. The Ashes will be held from August 1st to September 16th. One expects breathtaking action in Test cricket's biggest battle. The 12th edition of the Indian Premier League is expected to be held from March 29th onwards. Meanwhile, the Indian cricket team will be involved in a 3-match ODI series against Australia this month. India will face New Zealand in 5 ODIs and 3 T20s. India also face Australia in 5 ODIs and 2 T20s in February and March. Tennis will have its 4 mega Grand Slam events like every year. The Australian Open from January 14th to 27th. The French Open from May 26th to June 9th. Wimbledon from July 1st to 14th will be followed by US Open from August 26th to September 8th. There are also the major football events. The Champions League final will be held in Madrid on June 2nd. The FA Cup finale will take place at Wembley on May 18th. The Nations League final will be on June 9th, followed by Africa Cup of Nations from June 15th till July 13th. The Euro 2020 qualifiers will be held from March to November 2019. Athletics will witness the World Championship in Doha from September 28th to October 6th. It will be followed by the Para Athletics World Championship in Dubai from November 7th to 15th, and the Formula One season that starts from March and will end in December. With inputs from Astha Kulshresht, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
From an imminent showdown in US Congress over Trump's Mexico wall to looming Brexit deadline and the opening of Indo-Pakistan-Kartarpur corridor, 2019 is going to be an eventful year in the international arena. Here's a look at what to expect.
Elsewhere across the globe in the US, President Donald Trump ushered in the new year in a partial shutdown mode. This is over Trump's insistence on funding for the US-Mexico wall and the Democrats refusing to yield to his demands. The US Congress is now set for fireworks this year. With the standoff turning into a test of strength between Trump and the Democrats, who are now in majority in the House of Representatives after the midterm elections.
Elections to the US Congress. But that again, you've seen the results have not worked. And on January 1, that is today, in fact, it's not even in America. When America wakes up, they'll have a new Congress.
Yeah.
They have a new Congress. So the new Congress means what? A new Congress means the Democrats are in control of the House. House, as you know, is equivalent to a Lok Sabha, and that will control the power of the purse. So President Trump and his administration, which has a slight advantage in the Senate, would find it extremely difficult to get things moving. So that's where already you've seen there's a lockdown. A lockdown intense, the people haven't voted. So the government of the United States, is many departments are shut down. because there's no money to pay. Of course, these are the challenges. So it's just about begin this part of the thing.
Another step that Trump took will have far-reaching consequences this year. That was on 19th of December when Trump abruptly ordered U.S. troops to withdraw from Syria within 30 days, stating that ISIS has been defeated.
We've been fighting for a long time in Syria. I've been president for almost 2 years, and we've really stepped it up. And we have won against ISIS. We've beaten them, and we've beaten them badly. We've taken back the land, and now it's time for our troops to come back home. I get very saddened when I have to write letters or call parents or wives or husbands of soldiers who have been killed, fighting for our country.
However, as the year ended, he agreed to give the military more time to withdraw. Trump's order forced U.S. Defense Secretary to quit soon after. The move is expected to have serious consequences for the U.S.'s commitment in its fight against ISIS that still has over 17,000 fighters in Syria, as per Pentagon's estimates. Over 2,000 U.S. troops are in Syria. With the U.S. presidential campaign set to begin in the latter half of the year, the developments indicate a bumpy ride for the U.S. president this year. 2019 holds out hope for India's case for freeing Kulbhushan Jadhav from the Pakistan prison. The International Court of Justice will hold public hearings from 18th to 21st of February in Hague. In May last year, the ICJ restrained Pakistan from executing Jadhav till adjudication of the case. A former Indian naval officer, Kulbhushan Jadhav, was arrested by Pakistan on 3rd of March 2016. He was sentenced to death by a Pakistani military court in April 2017 on charges of spying and terrorism, charges that have been vehemently denied by India in its case in the ICJ. The Brexit deadline of March 29th is looming large over the United Kingdom. The vote on May's Brexit deal with the EU is slated to take place in the week beginning January 14th. The vote will determine whether Britain follows Theresa May's plan for Brexit. In case MPs vote out May's deal, she will have 21 days to return to Parliament with another plan, which seems a far cry. With time running out, British Prime Minister Theresa May urged lawmakers to back her Brexit deal as the country stepped into 2019.
In the next few weeks, MPs will have an important decision to make. If Parliament backs the deal, Britain can turn a corner. The referendum in 2016 was divisive, but we all want the best for our country. 2019 can be the year we put our differences aside and move forward together into a strong new relationship with our European neighbours and out into the world as a globally trading nation.
The biggest concern right now for Britain is to crash out of the European Union without a deal to fall back on.
So the big one is coming up, the Brexit, how it's because Theresa May's vote just survived. So she needs to go through it, sit through it, ensure that her Brexit policy is accepted by the House of Commons, which means if she gets her way out, the Britons will have voted for the Brexit policy, then Brexit and EU. So these are the other issues. Of course, we have many other issues on bilaterals, but then how does US and China trade is coming to a big thing. They've talked about some kind of an agreement, but these are policies and relationship that affects everyone.
With the UK out of European Union, the elections to the European Parliament will take place in May between 23rd and 26th of the month. Currently, a total of 751 members of the European Parliament represent over 500 million people from 28 member states. Post-Brexit, there will be 705 members of the European Parliament. For the first time, Japan will host the G20 summit in Osaka in June 28-29. There, it will put issues ranging from global trade imbalances to the impact of aging populations on the agenda. The 2019 summit is expected to focus on international finance and economic issues and global themes related to United Nations 2030 Sustainable Development Goals. This year may become easier for the Sikh pilgrims to visit the Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Kartarpur in Pakistan through the Indo-Pak Kartarpur corridor, which is expected to be operational by November. India and Pakistan are finalizing the finer details of the pilgrims' visit and the duration of their stay on the Pakistani site. Both countries are expecting to formally inaugurate the corridor on the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak in November 2019. With inputs from Asako Shrech, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, that's it from us in this edition of In-Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow with focus on some other subject. You can also watch our episodes online on YouTube and Twitter and get back to us with your valuable feedback and suggestions. Thanks for your time.